As content creators, it can quickly become overwhelming when we need to come up with good content ideas, create the content, schedule and manage it on different platforms, and a multitude of other things besides just creating content. Now, I'd be absolutely losing my mind if I didn't have the right systems in place to make my content creation process effortless and enjoyable. And that's exactly what this video is about, to help content creators such as yourself manage your content production and save you hours of time every single week. This video will be a full walkthrough of my Notion dashboard for content creators, which can be found as the first link in the description. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Starting off on the left of the dashboard, you'll see you have a quick notes section, and underneath you have all of your individual pages. And then on the right, you have a buttons widget for all your social media profiles, your content projects, the tasks for each project. And at the bottom, you have a calendar with a view for your tasks, as well as a view for your content schedule. Let's start with the buttons widget. To create one for yourself, you'll need to go to indiefy.co, create an account, scroll down, and then click on create a new button widget. Here you want to add your button name, add in the link to your profile, and add an icon. Now, you used to be able to add icons from different companies, like the one on the dashboard, but for some reason they removed that option, which I still don't understand why, but I'm sure Notion will soon add an external linking option to the native Notion buttons. Anyways, give your button an icon and select your theme color. If you're using dark mode, just quickly scroll down and select the dark mode option. To make the button transparent so you just have an outline, click on the advanced colors and change the background color to Notion's dark mode, which has the hex code 191919. And obviously, if you're using light mode, then just make it white. And then lastly, for the colors, you want to make the text white if you're using dark mode, and make the text dark if you're using light mode. After changing the colors, you want to scroll down and go to the corner rounding settings and select the round option. Now, if you want multiple buttons, then all you need to do is just click on the button menu and select copy to duplicate the button. When you're done setting up your buttons, you want to copy the link at the bottom and then paste it inside of your dashboard as an embed. Drag it on top of the placeholder widget, resize it, and delete the existing widget. Now let's get into how the dashboard works, starting with the content tracker. Here you have a view for all your active content, a view for all your content grouped by the platform, a view for your ideas, and a view for all your finished content projects. So let's go to the ideas view and create a new content project. Let's give it a name and then select the relevant template button based on the platform. And then let's add a publishing date, the type of content it is, and leave out the URL property as that will be for the actual link after we've posted. And then at the bottom, you'll find five different relation properties, which are these four pages on the left. The fifth being the task database on the dashboard. The first relation is to the same content tracker, so you can link two pieces of content with each other if they're about the same topic. Next, you have a relation to the bookmarks database where you can save other people's content that you find useful or want to recreate into your own. Then you have a relation to the platform, which already has the relevant platform selected thanks to the template button. You have your topics relation, so you can add a relevant topic for your piece of content. And lastly, you have a relation to the task database, which we'll get to shortly. If we go back to the content tracker and change the status of the project to one in the in progress options, the content project will move to the active view, sorted according to the publishing date, as well as move to the second view, where it's grouped according to the platform. Now for the task database. When we create a new task under the today view, it will automatically add today's date, and we just have to select the relevant template button so we can add an icon, as well as relate the task to the content tracker so that we can track the progress of our tasks through the progress bar. This database has a view showing our daily tasks, a view showing all the tasks due after today, a view showing all the tasks grouped by the content, a view for all your unscheduled tasks, as well as a view for all your completed tasks. And then at the bottom of the dashboard, we have our calendar to schedule our tasks and plan our day, week, and month ahead. And we also have a content calendar view showing the publishing dates for each piece of content, so we can plan out our content schedule. Now it's time to go through the pages on the left. First off, we have the virtual assistant page containing 100 personalized Notion AI prompts, which you can use to help you create content and grow on social media, Twitter and YouTube, as well as improve your branding. You simply open up one of these sections and click generate on the prompt block, and the AI will spit out new ideas, information and tips. And if you want to reset the prompt, don't delete the whole block, just delete the content inside. Now, I'm of course not going to go through each of these prompts, as this is something that you can explore and play around with on your own. Moving on, we have the finance tracker. I've already made a full video about this template, which you can find in the card above or in the description below, though I'll still be doing a quick walkthrough on how it works inside of this video. At the top, you have your finance tracker where you can quickly add new income or expenses under the today views. You can add the amount, the income or expense source, and relate it to a bank account. This database also has two views for both the income and expenses grouped according to the month, calculating the total, as well as a view where both the income and expenses are grouped together according to the month, but this time displaying the total profit. Underneath the finance tracker, you have your bank accounts database, which will automatically update the total bank balance as you add new income or expenses. And before you use this finance tracker, just go into your bank accounts and set the starting amount, which is the amount that you currently have in that bank account. Then you have your subscription tracker where you can add new subscriptions, link it to a bank account, add in the renewal date, add the amount and billing type, which will automatically calculate the monthly and yearly cost formulas at the bottom, and then also add a subscription type and an icon. For the subscription tracker, you have a normal list view as well as a table view calculating the total monthly amount at the bottom. All your subscriptions will show up on the subscription calendar, and each time a subscription is due, you just want to extend the renewal date ahead with 1 month and also manually add it to your expense tracker. Then lastly, at the bottom of the finance tracker, we have our different income and expense sources displaying the total amount for each. Our next page is the posting schedule. Here you can plan out what type of content you want to publish for each day and each platform. Simply add in the name, the type of content, and the time you want to post it. You can also add a description inside each post, explaining what it's about if you wish. Moving on, we have the four databases that's linked to our content tracker, starting with the first one being the content tracker itself. Here you have the active view, a view for all of your ideas grouped to the platform, a calendar view showing the publishing date, a table view with all your published content, and the view with no filters grouped to the platform. Then we have the bookmarks database. Here you can easily drag the bookmark to change its status and drop it into archives when you're done. Inside the bookmark, you can add the type of bookmark, the creator of the content, a link to the content, you can upload the content directly to Notion, and you can also relate the bookmark to a platform, topic, and to your content tracker. You can also use the Notion Web Clipper Chrome extension to save your content directly to this database, or if you're on your phone, just share the content to Notion and then select this database. Next up, we have the Topics and Platforms databases. Both of these are just a simple gallery view where you can add more topics or platforms, and then inside the Platforms database, you can also add a link to your profile for that platform. Then we have both a separate YouTube and Twitter page. For the YouTube one, you have your content workflow and a roadmap database at the bottom where you can list out what you need to do and want to achieve for each subscriber milestone. As for the workflow itself, you simply add in a new video idea and it will load a template button that will generate everything you could possibly need for creating a video. You can add the video metadata such as keywords and title ideas. You can script and plan out your video. You can use the editing database to make sure that you've made all the necessary edits. And then at the bottom, you have links to useful resources that will help you in creating your videos. Now, if we scroll to the top and take a look at the properties, you'll see we have a status property, which is what these two databases are filtered to. The first view shows everything that is not one of these completed options, and the second view shows all the videos that are completed. Then we have the publish date, which will make the video show up on the calendar. We have a URL property where you can add the link to the video once it's published. You can add a number, which is what the database views are sorted to, and it also relates to the order of videos you post. You can give your video a topic, a target duration, as well as select if it's monetized or sponsored. And if you want to make changes to the YouTube template, then just click the dropdown next to New and edit the template button. The second to last page is for scheduling Twitter content directly from Notion. If you click show description and click on the link above, it will take you to Q, which is the app you need to download and install. To do this, just click get started, select how you're using Notion and download the app. Then just open up the app, install it, and once it's done, just click on exit and also restart your Notion. When you open up Notion again, you want to click on the page menu, go to connections, search for Q, and then add it as a connection. Then go to the Q menu in the top right by clicking on these four squares, connect your Twitter database and make sure your Twitter account is also connected. When you save these changes, you should now be able to schedule tweets straight from Notion. When you go ahead and create a new database entry and start typing inside of the page, you'll see a Twitter preview on the right. If you want to create a thread, then just use the divider, and if you want to add images, then simply use an image block. When your tweet is done, you can change its status to ready and give it a publish date and time. Once your tweet is posted, it will automatically move to published, and when you open it up, you'll now see this metrics formula. If you click on show hidden properties, you'll be able to add the amount of impressions, profile clicks, likes, replies, and retweets, which will show up inside the metrics summary. Now for the last and final page, which is for your phone. On your phone, you want to add a widget to this Notion page, so when you're on the go, you can quickly pull up Notion and add whatever you need to remember. And then when you're at your computer again, you can just organize the note into a task, new content idea, or whatever you want. And there you go. Now you know how to manage your life as a content creator using the Notion dashboard, linked in the description below. Thank you for watching, and be sure to check out this next video showing you how to use Notion to manage your life if you're also a freelancer.